Going to the local gym and hiring a certified personal trainer can be hazardous to your health, as this story here explains.
Yeah, let's go four more.
Two more legs, come on. Last one right here.
Like anyone who has ever hired a certified personal trainer, Dr. Jacob Ulferson trusted his trainer completely. Trusted him even when an intense exercise called a step up began to cause him severe pain.
He had excruciating pain in his lower back. He lost the feeling in his leg.
Andy Custer, Dr. Ulferson's attorney, says Ulferson injured a disc in his back that day when the trainer urged him to ignore the pain. This was his testimony.
I attempted to stop the exercise, but was pushed against my will.
Pushed against his will, meaning keep going?
Keep going, this is good for you. Just finish the exercise.
The trainer who worked at this Gold Gym in Florida denies the incident ever happened, but both his insurance company and the gym settled out of court. Dr. Ulferson did not want to comment, but his lawsuit raises a serious question. Is a certified trainer always qualified?
The trainer, during a pretrial deposition, was asked what made him a certified personal trainer. He was certified, he insisted, through a mail order course consisting of a single textbook followed by a 4-hour exam.
There's a real risk of being injured.
Professor Larry Hamm, who teaches exercise science at George Washington University,
all right, we'll go another 10,
warns that health club consumers are on their own. With more than 200 certifications available, Hamm says some trainers are first-rate experts in everything from physiology to body fat composition, while others simply buy a credential online.
You're saying you can pay $40, $100 on the internet.
Right.
And what happens?
And you'll end up getting a certificate in the mail that you can put on your wall that claims you're a certified something.
Are you certified?
Absolutely.
In any gym in America, the certifications listed by the trainers are all over the map.
And National Academy of Sports Medicine.
National Athletic Training Association.
National certification with NSPA.
So many health clubs protect themselves and their clients by using outside contractors like Wolf Gottschalk to hire the trainers. He requires a college degree in exercise, not just a certification.
There are so many acronyms out there for certifications that, and there is no industry standard into becoming a trainer.
I want you to tell me where you would have him stop his squat.
Other gyms train the trainers themselves. In this billion-dollar industry where training can cost more than $100 an hour, business is pumped, but high demand is part of the problem. Pretenders are blending in with the profession.
Excellent. Good job.
In Washington, Wyatt Andrews for Eye on America.
Now that is scary. You hire a personal trainer because you assume that a certified trainer is an expert, and many times they are not. Here at Sensible Fitness Personal Training, all of our trainers are not only certified and insured, but they are qualified. All protocols used here are approved by a medical doctor, not a chiropractor, a medical doctor, and an orthopedic surgeon, and a dietitian, and a physical therapist. Feel free to contact us for a no obligation fitness assessment. Or if you want more information on this TV show, give us a call. Phone number's there on the screen, along with our website, sensiblefitness.com. We look forward to helping you.